Let's take it up a notch and take a look at these some indifference identities and see what we can do with them in this question. Look at this. I gave you sine P and I gave you cos Q, but look what I'm going to do. Oh my goodness, what am I going to do? Okay, well, it's actually kind of easy because look, I've given you where sine P actually is. I told you that sine P is somewhere in the first quadrant between 0 and pi over 2. It's got to be in this first quadrant. So what does this sine P mean? This, of course, means the opposite. This, of course, means the hypotenuse, doesn't it? Ah, so opposite 3, hypotenuse is 5. Let's just draw any old angle out here, which you know is going to make a nice 90 degrees. There's the theta reference that we refer to, and in this case, that's our p-value. Oh, of course, right? Opposite is 3, hypotenuse is 5. X squared plus y squared equals r squared, or simply a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Right? So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Pythagoras from grade 7 or grade 8. So this is, of course, going to be 3 squared plus b squared, we don't know. C squared is going to be 5 squared. So check this out. B squared is going to be 25 minus 9. B squared, of course, is going to be 16. Square root, b is going to equal to 4. Oh my, that was really simple. So is this going to be a plus or minus 4? Well, when we square root, it is a plus or minus 4. But the fact that we're putting it into the first quadrant means that you have to make this a positive 4 because you're going positive 4 direction, positive 3 direction. Okay? Very, very important. So there's our p value. And from here, think about it. Now I can figure out my cosine. I can figure out my tangent values. I can do anything I want with this. All right, let's do the same thing to this one down here. Here we go. Brrup, brrup. This is now pi over 2 to pi. So we're going from pi over 2 here to pi over here. Aha. Okay, so this is, again, cosine. So that's got to be adjacent over hypotenuse. Okay, adjacent over the hypotenuse. Adjacent over the hypotenuse, and your angle's got to be out here. Beautiful. Okay, so let's finish this guy off. Adjacent then, of course, has got to be the minus 5 because look at it. It's going in a negative direction. There's minus 5. This has got to be the 13. There's your hypotenuse. So, of course, now you got to figure out the b again. So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Or better yet, b squared is c squared minus a squared. You know how to do that. Again, grade 7 or grade 8 when you first saw that. So b squared, c squared is 13 squared, which is 169. A squared is going to be minus 25. Ah, okay, so we're dealing with some bigger numbers here. So what does b squared end up being? B squared ends up being, oh my goodness, if you look at this, this is going to be 169 minus 25. Isn't that 144? Sure, square root, b works out to be plus or minus 12. So is it plus 12 or minus 12? Look at the direction it's in. It's in the positive direction. So that's going to be a plus 12. Okay, now that we've got all this, let's clean this up a little. Perfect. All right, now, let's just use the double angle identities now and figure out what this is. This is the sine of P minus Q. So we're dealing with a difference identity of sine, which is right here. So let's write this out. So instead of P's and Q's, instead of A's and B's, we're going to use P's and Q's. Okay, so wherever there's a, put a P down. Wherever there's a B, put a Q down. Look how easy this becomes. Oh my goodness. So this P minus Q becomes sine P, right? Cos Q. Wow. Okay. Subtract cos P sine Q. Perfect. So what is sine P? What is cos P? Well, wait a second. We can figure that out just by looking at these guys. That's easy. Okay, sine P, of course, is 3 over 5 because it says right in the question, sine P is 3 over 5. Cos Q, oh, we can figure that guy out. That's 5 over 13. Oh, pretty. Subtract now. Okay, what's cos of P? Well, there's sine of P. That's why we did this. You see that? Now we know that the cos of P, which you know the cos of anything, is adjacent over the hypotenuse, adjacent being 4, and the hypotenuse being 5. So the cos of P then is 4 over 5. Ah, the sine of Q then, all right, there's Q here. The sine of Q, of course, we know sine of Q, again, is opposite over hypotenuse, the opposite being 12, the hypotenuse being 13. Oh, sweet. So all I have to do now is just multiply this whole crazy thing out. Yeah, of course. That times that, that times that. So if you think about it, 3 times 5 works out to be, oh, look at that, minus 15. 5 times 13 is 65, minus, oh, look at this, 4 times 12, which is 48. 5 times 13, 65. Oh, my goodness. So all I have to do is just kind of combine these. Well, when I combine this, I'm going to get minus 63 over 65. There's my exact value. Oh, just because I did some initial legwork here and here to figure some stuff out, this actually becomes a walk in the park. Okay, so how do you do secant then? Well, that's got to be interesting, hey? Well, just remember what secant is. Secant is 1 over cos, right? So this is like saying 1 over cos p plus q. Well, why don't we figure out the cos of p plus q here and then flip our answer? Because we can do that. So there's cos. So wherever there's an a, put a p now. Look at that. Okay. Wherever there's a b, put a q. Oh, how absolutely wonderful. So this works out to be equals to, this will be cos p, right? Okay. Times cos q minus sine p times sine of q. Beautiful. Excellent. Excellent. Cos of p. Well, let's go back up here and figure out what cos of p was. Cos of p. Cos of p. We don't have it. Okay, so go to this guy. There's our p. Cos of p is going to be 4 over 5. Oh, how sweet. Okay, cos of p, 4 over 5. Cos of q, I think we had that in the question, didn't we? All the way back here. Yep. Cos of q was negative 5 over 13. Hey, that's easy enough to do. Negative 5 over 13. Subtract the sine of p, I think, was given, right? The sine of p, yeah, there it is, 3 over 5. Let's write that in there as well. The sine of p is 3 over 5. And the sine of q, we have to figure out, well, there's q, of course, is opposite over hypotenuse, which, of course, is going to be 12 over 13. Ah, how sweet, 12 over 13. Okay, straight out multiply. You multiply these guys out, you get minus 20 over 65. Multiply this guy out, you get minus 36 over, over 65 again. Oh, how nice. Okay, so put these guys together, you end up getting minus 56 over 65. Sweet. Okay, so is that our answer? No, that's for cosine. What is secant? Secant is 1 over cosine. So all you have to do to find the answer for this one is flip it. This now is 65 over minus 56. Done. Wow. Okay, that's really, really simple. Let's go do the last one. Oh, can it be tan? Absolutely is tan. So you know what might be an advantage here? Let's write out all of the tans of P's and Q's. Let's do it right now based on what we have. Let's find out tan of P. Let's find out tan of Q. Let's actually write it down so we don't have to flip this thing back and forth. So I'm going to go all the way back here to where I wrote out P, which is right here. There's P, and I'm going to figure out the tan of P. The tan of P is opposite over adjacent. That's 3 over 4. So that becomes really advantageous to us to have it kind of at our fingertips. Let's do the tan of Q. Okay, tan of Q is going to be 12 over minus 5. Okay, that makes sense. 12 over minus 5. Now, let's do the identity. The identity for this one is tan P plus Q. So that is a sum identity. That's this guy right here. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's see if I can grab this thing and mouse it down here to somewhere where I can actually use it. Okay, beautiful. Let's go. Right down to here. Oh, there it is. Right down to here. Look at how pretty that is. Beautiful. Let's use it. Okay, so here we go. That's the one we're after. All right, let's do it. This is going to be tan of A, tan of B. So put in wherever you see an A, put in a P. All right, there's a P. There's a P. Wherever there's a B, put in the Q. That's a Q. That's a Q. So we want tan of P plus tan of Q over 1 minus tan P times tan, oh my goodness, tan of Q. All right, so let's put in the values in. Tan of P, of course, is 3 over 4. So this will be 3 over 4 plus tan of Q. Tan of Q, where are you, tan of Q? Oh, there you go, minus 5 over 12. Or no, sorry, minus 12 over 5. Oh, minus 12 over 5. Beautiful, we've got that down, right? Yep, okay. And let's finish off the bottom of this guy. Oh, I need some more room here. Okay, the bottom is 1 minus tan P. What was tan P again? Oh, gotta move it up now. Tan P was 3 quarters. 3 quarters, right? Times tan of Q. Well, tan of Q we know is minus 12 over 5. Beautiful. Oh, my goodness. I think the hardest part of this is working with the fractions, okay? You know you can put that in your calculator using the alpha button, right? Okay, but if you're a purist like I am, which, eh, maybe it's my fault, I know I like my common denominators. So I've got my 15 over 20 plus, multiply that by 4, multiply that by 4. There's my minus 48 over 20. Put those guys together, I get minus 33 over 20 on the top. That's what I got on top there. Okay, now next one, let's do this one. Oh my goodness, straight out multiply this out. You know that this is 1 minus, okay, 3 times minus 12 is minus 36 over 4 times 5 is 20. Oh my goodness, I've got to make sure that I can combine these guys, right? Huh, that makes this interesting. This is now 20 over 20. Right, because that's what 1 is. 20 over 20 minus a minus 36 gives me 56. Oh my goodness, over 20. And that's division. Well, that, come on, that's not so tough. Minus 33 over 20 divided by 56 over 20. Take the reciprocal and multiply. Oh, holy smokes, the 20s cancel out to give me minus 33 over 56. That's what the 10 works out to be. What a great question.